Well, hi everybody, and welcome to the Elluminate Setup Guide for Moodle. Now, as always, we're going to begin at our main course page and go to the upper right-hand corner and turn Editing On. As Elluminate is an online activity, I'm going to go to Topic Area 4, which I set up in advance for guest speakers, and using the drop-down, I'm going to choose Add an Activity, and there we see Elluminate Live Session. Give it a click and you're prompted to set up your course. Now the title will appear on your Moodle page, so I'm cutting and pasting here to save time. I'm going to call the title Guest Speaker and give a date of the event. I'm then going to come down to the session name, and this is going to be called A Discussion with James Lee Burke. Happens to be one of my favorite authors. Again, cutting and pasting. And the description box is very useful. Here is where to list connection or participation details for your class, perhaps some guest bio information, and you can even include a photo relevant to the class topic. This is going to appear when students prepare to join the actual session, so simple reminders on how to log in and what to expect would be useful here as well. Now I jumped over session type, which is right under our title, so let's go take a look at that. By default, you're going to want to use course. You have the option, as we check the drop-down, of making it private. This would be good for a faculty-student conference, or group if you have set up groups. Now I'm going to choose group and scroll down to the bottom of the page, and notice we have group mode, separate groups, or visible groups. These are groups you have, of course, set up in advance. When I return to the course setting, the groups are grayed out. This is not an option. Let's come down and let's look at our session beginning and ending. Fairly self-explanatory. We have military time in play, so if you're going to begin at noon and end up at 4, make sure you do it at 1600, not 0400, or you're going to get an error message. By default, notice it says boundary time. You may get in 30 minutes prior to the actual session beginning. Let's look at session recording. By default, we have manual. Manual is set up so that you can turn it on or you can turn it off. Clicking the drop-down, we also have disabled, which means it's off, period, or automatic, which means it's on and you have no control. I prefer to use manual. I like to display the boundary time so people know how early they can get into the class, and if you're going to grade attendance, that's something you can set up. And if you have a grade category, I'm going to choose participation, and I'm going to choose 25 points for this activity. Okay, you're ready to go. Let's save and return to the course. There is our guest speaker link. I'm going to select it. Here's where you see your description. Here's where your information appears with the ending and beginning time. Editing moderators is not necessary in Moodle. By default, the instructor is a moderator and the student is a guest. Adding a preloaded file is useful only for adding whiteboard information. If you want to upload a PowerPoint or do a web tour, all of that is done inside the session. If you need to verify your system setup, that's below Join Session. We've already done that. We recommend you do it at least a day prior to your first actual session. I'm going to select Join Session to show you what actually happens when you do this. We're using Firefox. It says, do you want to do this? It's going to download Java. You'll see an Elluminate Live window pop up. It should say V10 for version 10. There'll be some connection drama when you get going, and eventually you are here inside the Elluminate window. Lots going on. The first two things you need to know come to the lower corner. It says, do you want to start recording? Not right now, because we're early for the class. Right where you clicked is a lot of setup information for your microphone, your teleconferencing, your audio, your recording. You'll find out all of this in your actual Elluminate training. And for information on that, go to the campus training website. We have a number of sessions available coming up in the month of May. You may also always call the Moodle office at 3633. And there are a number of options available on the HSU website as well. So there's plenty of help available. This is a wonderful utility, and I look forward to seeing you all in an Elluminate class. If you have any Moodle questions, for heaven's sakes, give us a call at 3633, because, what do I always say, we're here to help.